2020. I think more important that our names in this target could be the name of the country. I'm representing Cape Verde Islands. I will try to make this introduction in 5 minutes. I have 3 issues. The first one, I will give you a picture of Cape Verde in the last decade. The second will be how Cape Verde has been coping with the international crisis. And third, Cape Verde as a middle-income country and the new risks within the new international environment. It seems that in the past 4 weeks, something very bad is going on outside. Cape Verde, for someone that doesn't know, we are 10 volcanic islands out of West Africa, right in front of Senegal. We are a small island country, 500,000 inhabitants. I used to say no bigger than a neighborhood in New York. And in 2008, we have been graduated from a LDC country, a least development country, to a middle income country. The last decade, we got our independence in 75. We were a Portuguese colony. We speak Portuguese. So English is not my mother language. What we did in from 2000 to 2010, our average annual growth, GDP growth has been 6.2% from 2000 to 2010. Our inflation was, average inflation was around 2%. Our GDP per capita has increased by 80% from 2000 to 2010. We managed to reduce poverty from 37% to 24%, and in 2007 we managed to reach 4 out of the 8 MDG goals. But Cape Verde has no natural resources. We did all that, but we have no natural resources. We are only 4,000 square kilometers. We are more sea than land. We are 800 square kilometers of sea. Since we have no natural resources, of course, we are becoming more economy based on services. Indeed, the services sector has reached 75% of our GDP. In the last 10 years, we managed to, so Cape Verde economic growth has been mainly based on capital accumulation. We managed to reach an average of 40% of GDP in terms of physical capital formation, 40% of GDP. In terms of human accumulation of human capital, we managed to reach an average of 25%, but we still have a big challenge, which is the productivity. The contribution has been around only 5%. So Cape Verde, despite the fact it is a small country, has no natural resources, managed to put these macroeconomic indicators on the table. Thanks essentially to, in my perspective, in my opinion, to a strong, good governance. At the end of the day, institutions do matter. At the end of the day, institutions do matter. So in the last 10 days, we have bet on hard issues, but also on soft issues. Of course, we work our roads, our schools, our maritime ports, our airports, but at the same time, we have worked our soft issues, human capital, our institutions, our democratic framework, etc., etc. So, how Cape Verde has been coping with international crisis? such small country. We are an open economy. So the international crisis hits, and it's hardly on Cape Verde. Basically, after our graduation in 2008, we made an agreement with the international community. So please, we have been graduated, but we still have a high level of vulnerability. So give us 8 to 10 years in terms of transition period, so you can keep enjoying financial concessional financing, so we can infrastructure our country at a very low cost, and then we promise that we put economic growth on the table. And we'll make this graduation, we'll put this graduation under a sustainable this agreement has helped Cape Verde also to cope with the international crisis, because when the international crisis hit Cape Verde, it hit from the external demand side. FDI flows decreased, remittance decreased, exports decreased, and of course fiscal revenues decreased. What we try to do, we try to increase our domestic demand by increasing our public investment program. By doing that, of course, deficit went up, and the level our public debt went up. Despite the deficit and the debt both went up, the debt is within sustainable limits. Why? Because we adopt a very strict rule. Cape Verde only contracts concessional financing. Don't put on the table commercial loans proposal, because unfortunately we have not reached the level to accept this type of funding, this type of financing. In fact, under our policy support instrument with the IMF, we have a limit for non-concessional financing of 35 million. We have not used in 2011 this limit. 2009, as I mentioned, the international crisis hit Cape Verde. Our growth rate went down around 4%. But in 2010, we start a recover. Everybody was happy, not only Cape Verde, I believe, but everybody was happy. But in 2011, we have been facing this eurozone risk. And in the case of Cape Verde, is an important question, because 90% of our exports are to Europe, are to Portugal, Italy, and Spain. So, the tree of the pigs. We export 90% to the pigs, which is not something that I would say that is comfortable nowadays. What are our medium-term risks? And this is the last item of my intervention. My speech. Now Cape Verde is a middle income, and it seems that he might, with this adverse international context, we might be running a risk to be grabbed by what they call the middle income trap. The countries that have been graduated, they did very well. They managed to be graduated, but they didn't manage to stay on a sustainable path in the middle income level. And Cape Verde now is facing this challenge. My question is, under this international context, what is the role of the World Bank and IMF institutions for Cape Verde and for African countries? The Cape Verdean position is very clear, very clear. We think that World Bank or the Bretton Woods institution should continue supporting Africa, and they should see this support as part of the solution of the problem and not part of the problem. They need to see this support as part of the solution of this international crisis. Because my question is, if Cape Verde, without natural resources, manage to grow at a 6% average for 10 years, And to put all these results on the table, can you imagine an Ivory Coast? Can you imagine Nigeria or other countries? So there is a great potential in Africa, a huge potential in Africa. So I think we should be seen as part of the solution for this international crisis. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Minister Duarte.